Hi everyone, in this video I'll demonstrate how to use Atom IDE for Python development. In the previous videos about Python, I was just using text editor for writing the Python script. So once you start using IDE, which will simplify the code writing and maintenance of the code, there are some packages which even helps you to identify syntax error or maintaining the project and organize all the files. So first, to download this package, you can click here and download it. It supports on Linux, Windows and Mac OS, so it is completely free. So once you download it, so you can see the same file which I downloaded and kept it here. So for installing it in Linux, the command is dpkg-i. Yeah, once you execute it, it will install the package in the machine. Yeah, now installation has been completed. Now to open the software, yeah, it is opening the Atom. Okay, this is just a spell check error, we can ignore that. This is the welcome screen of that. Now here, so you can see I kept all the Python scripts, the previous Python scripts, in this folder data python 05 python demo. So if I want to open this project, I can just click on open project. I just need to give OK. Yeah, now you can see here all the Python scripts in this folder as replicated here, or it is showing it here. So if you want to send your usage data to the Atom metric package, or you can do that, or so these are the scripts which I recorded earlier. This was a simple script which executes a show command on a network device. We'll see how to run it. So for running Python script, you need to install the package inside Atom. For installing the package, you need to go to preferences. So here you will be able to see many settings. So core settings will be so this will affect the behavior of text editing, so you don't have to make any changes here. If you are interested, you can go and explore those features. So I'll be showing the bare minimum configuration which you need to do for testing your basic device interaction, terminal, and how to get the output from the device. Now, so one thing what you need to change here is the tab length. So tab length, we can keep it 4. That was a standard I was following while writing the code. Then you can see some keyboard shortcuts which is defined here. Then these are the packages installed in this. By default, it has installed all these packages. And if you want to here you can see the themes it supports, so you can explore all this. Now if you want to install any particular package, you need to come here. So here you can see you have two options, either to install packages or themes. So here I'll be showing a package which you can use for running the script and giving the input in terminal. So the package which I'm going to install is script runner, so I'll install that. Yeah, yeah, you can see this package. So run scripts and shell within a proper terminal. So I'll be installing this. The reason why I'm using this is because it gives a proper terminal for executing, because when we do the network device configuration or network level configuration, you will have a lot of terminal inputs involved. So I'm using this. Here you can see the keyboard shortcuts. So in Linux, the keyboard shortcut for running this is Alt X. Yeah, it is still installing. Now you can see installation has been completed. Now we'll try to execute one script. Okay, yeah, this was one of the Python 2.7 code, Python 2 code. So you can see here, by default I have defined my Python location. If you want to verify the default Python, so what we can do, Python hyphen v, so I'm getting 2.7.1.2, and if I give slash user bin Python, you can see it is Python 2.7.1.2. Okay, now let's try running this. So I'll execute Alt X. By pressing Alt X, you can see it has printed the output. So you can see the script, what it does, it executed a show version command. Now if you want to give it as an input, what you can do, so there is another script here, you can see it will take it as a input, raw input in Python 2.7. Now I'll execute Alt X. So you can see it is asking to give the command. I'll give show run, enter. So you can see here, this has printed the output. So similar way, if you want to use it a Python 3 script, what you can do is user bin Python 3. Yeah, this is Python 3 code. My device IP is 172.18.1.1. The username and password I hard coded here. So it is using it. Now I'll show you how to install a specific version of Python and use that, or how to install a virtual environment. Once you use virtual environment, the advantage is it won't impact your base machine's Python. You can install any package inside that virtual environment and use it. Now before that, we will verify the default Pythons in my machine. So what we can do here, to see the default Python, so you can see it is 2.7.1.2. Now I'll give Python 3. You can see the default Python is 3.5.2. So now I'll show you how to install another version of Python.